Stump the Apologist, what's your name?
Hi, Randy Barnett.
Randy, what's your question?
Well, as a Catholic, it seems like we're always getting beat up for worshiping Mary, is, you know, what the evangelicals tell us. Mm-hmm. I'd like to know, what does the Bible really say about our relationship is to be with Mary?
Well, something I always say to Protestants or fellow Christians who have problems with Mary, I would say, well, you know, we don't want to love Mary too much. I would suggest just love her as much as Jesus loved her, and no more than that. And that usually leaves them, it's kind of a pause follows for a few seconds. Because, of course, we know that it's not possible to love Mary more than Jesus loved Mary, that he loved his mother. He fulfilled the fourth commandment more than anyone else could fulfill it, of loving his mother absolutely fully with this great love. Now, obviously, the church has always taught that Mary is not divine in any way. She's absolutely fully human. And so we don't worship her. And that's an easy answer. We don't. We do give her honor. We love her. We venerate her. We do believe that she's holy. And we see already in the New Testament, for a good Bible answer, we see when Mary comes and visits Elizabeth with the account of the visitation, mm-hmm. we see how this account is very much modeled on 2 Samuel 6, where the Ark of the Covenant, King David brings the Ark of the Covenant to Jerusalem. And he says, how can it be that the Ark of my Lord comes to me? And the Ark, he goes into the hills of Judea, says this, and then he remains, is it 3 or 6 months that the Ark remains there in the house of Obed-Edom in the hills of Judea. Now, when Mary goes and visits Elizabeth, what does Elizabeth say? How can it be that the mother of my Lord comes to me? And then John the Baptist dances, he jumps around in Elizabeth's womb, just like David danced around the Ark, and then the Ark remained in the hills of Judea for 6 months. And so we see Luke is already presenting the Mary as an Ark of the New Covenant. And so she's a beautiful woman, the mother of the Lord, the mother of the church, whom we love deeply and revere, but we don't worship her. We only worship God.
Great explanation. Thank you.
Thanks.